Thank you and welcome and good morning, everybody. I'm so happy to see you here today. Boy, we are a big school. It took a lot to get everybody in here today. So thank you. Boys and girls, I was thinking about this program last night. So many of you have been in this kindergarten show. It's a tradition here at Lipscomb. And I heard some sweet voices coming in here go, the show gets better every year. So we're so excited to be here today. And I was just thinking how thankful I am for each and every one of you, boys and girls. You are so amazing. And Lipscomb would not be Lipscomb without you. So thank you. And I wish each and every one of you and your families a very wonderful Thanksgiving. I just want to remind you that our kindergartners might be a little nervous coming up here today. So please make sure that we are a very respectful audience. We're not going to be kicking the bleachers or screaming or anything, but we do want to wave to them as they come in, welcoming them. And we want you all to stay seated. If you can see, we've got a lot of people. The program is not that long. So if we can hold off bathroom breaks until the show is over, we would really appreciate that. When the show's over, we're going to get our kindergartners to leave first, then we'll get everybody out, and we're going to do it again for the parents. Okay, so you all sit back, relax, enjoy, and just know how thankful we are for you, for our kindergartners. We are thankful.
Welcome to our show. We are thankful. Thank you.
running down.
A's for apple pie, so yummy to eat.
N is for neighbors at our house we all meet.
K is for kindness, it is always better to give than to take. S is for sharing all the food that we make.
T is for giving so others can enjoy.
I is for including every little girl and boy.
V is for vegetables that make us grow healthy and strong.
I is for Indians that have deer so fat.
N is for November, cool way is finally here.
G is for all our great blessings we celebrate each year.
Thank you. cooking something up for me.
Hey, sweet baby, don't you think, baby, we should try a brand new recipe?
Hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How's about cooking something up for me?
Hey, sweet baby, don't you think, baby, we should try a brand new recipe?
Everybody, hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How about cooking something up for me? Hey, sweet baby, don't take baby, we should try a brand new recipe.
Do you know what time it is? Do you know what time it is? Do you know what time it is? Turkey time.
Thank you. We are thankful for our family.
We are thankful for our friends.
We are thankful for our food.
We are thankful for our homes.
We are thankful for our clothes.
We are thankful for our school and country.
Let's have a big round of applause for our fabulous kindergartners. Thank you. We'd also like to take a minute to thank Mr. Andrelonis, who wrote and produced all of this for us today. And all of our specials teachers for helping out. We appreciate that. And finally, we just want to wave at our kindergarten teachers and tell them that their kids are absolutely precious. Okay, as my kindergartners are making their exit, where's Miss Brown? Do you have any more turkey trivia you can come up with? Come on up here for a minute. Let's think about this, Miss Roon. Do you remember any of your turkey trivia?
All right. Boys and girls, if you miss Power Monday, you miss a lot of cool facts. We do a segment every Monday about weird and wacky facts.
Fun fact of the day with Miss Brown. Hey!
All right, and this past week, it was turkey facts, because we're all gonna go home for Thanksgiving next week, and I said that I sure work with a bunch of turkeys on the specials team, so here's my weird and wacky turkey trivia. Listen really carefully, because if you come in the library today, and we ask you one of these, and you know the answer, you might get a little treat. Okay, listen. I gotta have you, everybody really quiet. Every turkey has between 5,000 and 6,000 feathers. That's a lot of feathers. The largest turkey ever recorded, 37 pounds. The best tasting turkeys are the oldest and the largest males. I read that the average turkey lives in about 1,000-acre area, and they're so smart, they know their way around that entire 1,000 acres. They like to sleep in trees or on fence posts to get away from all the predators. They're very social. They hang out with their family and friends most of the time. And Miss Contage, I'm trying to remember one more. Oh, this is sad. In the United States, next Thursday, we're gonna eat about 42 million turkeys.
We are